Hey YouTube, welcome back to Wiles HVAC and stuff. What do you do if you come to a furnace and it says reverse polarity? Most of these new furnaces, they've got diagnostic lights on them. They've got all kinds of things in that board to be able to pick up problems and issues that could be happening, be it inside the furnace or exterior to the furnace, whatever. One of the big things we see on there in modern furnaces, because modern furnaces are very sensitive to polarity and making sure they have a ground. So reverse polarity is one of those faults on there that we see a lot of times. It can change because of, either how it was wired in the factory, doesn't match the house, somebody changed some kind of electrical lines in the house somewhere, maybe even the utility company out there changed something with the electric on the house itself. Either way, reverse polarity is one that pops up once in a while. A lot of times brand new furnaces, they may make it a few days, they may make it a few weeks, or even a couple of years before all of a sudden they start showing it has reverse polarity. That's why my recommendation would be to any furnace you put in there, if it's a brand new furnace or if you're putting a brand new transformer in it, something like that, doing electrical work, always check the polarity. Just make sure it's right off the bat, and you don't have to worry about it later. So all we got to do is, I've got my basic meter. I think I've showed this meter before. Got a basic meter here. It's just a field piece SC260. There's a lot of different meters out there. As always, I recommend field piece. Been a good brand. They've been real good to me. Reasonable price, all that kind of stuff. So hopefully I've got that sitting where you can see it. First things first is see what kind of voltage you got coming in. So my furnace, you can see there's some extra wires in here. I do have a system monitoring system on here. There's a couple of wire harnesses that are kind of rolled up in here. There's some wires going back there for a air purifier, fan handler, a couple different things. So I have extra wires, so we're just going to focus on the transformer here itself. This black and white wire go all the way down to where the main power comes in from the breaker box, and then this 24 volts on top goes to the board itself. We could either you can trust me, that's where those wires go, or we can go through and hunt through all those extra wires, but I don't really care to right now, so you're gonna have to trust me. So this black wire and this white wire coming in, that's basically your main power coming in. So we've got, should have 120 on the black one, and this white one will be your neutral. So with the two of them together, we're showing 124.6, so that'd be normal, right? So okay, we've got good power coming into the furnace. And if we check the low voltage side, we have 28.3. That's actually fairly normal. But the one thing you have to make sure is if you have good polarity or not. So to check the polarity, down here where all your thermostat wires come in from your thermostat and go to the board, there's normally a little terminal strip there. One of them's labeled R. That's 24 volts. If you're already doing service work, you should know that. So that R is 24 volts hot. So if you put one lead on there, and then take your other lead and put it on the black wire, your L1 feeding the furnace or going to your transformer there, that one says 153. 153 volts is not correct. 153 volts would be reverse polarity. So at some point in time, this board could respond differently or not do what it's supposed to. So we need to fix that. So we already know the polarity is reversed on this transformer. One of the first things you want to do after you figure that out is we need to make sure that the furnace is grounded, because if the furnace is not grounded well, you'll never be able to correct the polarity no matter what you do. So we'll just do it the simple way. We've got our 120 volts coming in on that black wire, and we'll just find a place for a good case ground. We'll just find a good piece of metal that we know is bare, rub it around a little bit. We've got 124.6 volts. So we know that the furnace is grounded. There's no doubt that the furnace is grounded. So the other thing, how you fix that polarity, these low voltage wires that come in right here, you want to make sure you turn your power off, which let's pretend I did. Turn your power off, unplug both of those, swap them, and put them back. So we just traded places with the two low voltage wires. I do not recommend trading places with your black and your white. I've seen people out there on YouTube that do that. I don't recommend that, because at that point in time, that is reversing things in your breaker box, or how they're wired all the way back to to your breaker panel. I do not agree with that whatsoever. There are people out there that recommend it. I don't. So you can do what you want there, but all I'm doing is reversing the low voltage wires, because as long as you've got a good ground to the furnace and your low voltage wires or your 24 volt wires are in the right position there coming out of your transformer, you can always get good polarity. So, like I said, don't listen to those videos out there that are telling you to swap the white and the black, because that's messing with the entire house, not just that transformer there. So now we'll check it again and see if it's right. So again, we're going to go back to that R terminal on the low voltage. So that should be 24 volt hot to the thermostat. And we'll touch the other one to the black on our transformer. And we have 96 volts. That's correct. So that's the biggest thing to remember, is if you're checking polarity, 96 volts or somewhere between usually 94 and 98. Somewhere in that range. It all depends on how much voltage you have coming into the house. You know, if your house normally has 121 volts, you know, on one leg, or if it has 126 volts on one leg, you know, it's going to vary there on your voltage. But anything in the mid 90s, usually like I said, 94 to 98 is correct polarity. Anything that is around 150 up to 155, 156, that is reversed polarity. So reverse polarity needs to be changed. Like I said, I recommend checking the polarity on all new furnaces being put in. If you have a new wire ran to a furnace, definitely if you're changing a transformer, that's where a lot of them I think get reversed, is somebody comes in, says, well, your transformer failed. They put a new one in and they just slap the wires on there, because the board a lot of times will work. However, whichever way you put those low voltage wires on, but if you don't check it, you don't know if it's right. So it could be, like I said, a couple days, couple weeks, couple years down the road, all of a sudden it's going to say reverse polarity, and it's all because somebody replaced that transformer, you know, a couple years prior and didn't check anything. So always check your polarity, make sure it's right. Remember, about 94 to 98 is correct polarity, and 150 to 154 is reverse polarity. So make sure they're right, make sure you're checking. Any questions, leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thank you for watching the video, and make sure you share, like, and subscribe as much as possible. Thank you, and God bless.